Consider the following example. Calculate the dot product of vectors u and v if both are unit vectors and the angle between them is 5 pi over 6. Okay, so first of all, what's the definition of the dot product that we would use here? Well, the dot product of vectors u and v is defined as the magnitude of u times the magnitude of v times the cosine of theta, where theta is the angle between them. So, in this case, we're given all the information directly that we need to compute the dot product. We're told that u and v are both unit vectors, and that means that their magnitudes are 1. So the magnitude of u is 1, and the magnitude of v is 1, and we're told that the angle between them is 5 pi over 6. So we have the cosine of 5 pi over 6. So let's think about whether we expect our answer to be positive or negative. Well, 5 pi over 6 is an angle that's greater than pi over 2, but less than pi. So the cosine of that angle should be negative. So we expect that this dot product should be negative, and that's going to be the case whenever you do have an angle between pi over 2 and pi. Okay, in those cases, your dot product is going to be negative. So what's the cosine of 5 pi over 6? Well, that value, if you recall, is negative root 3 over 2. So that's our dot product in this case. Let's now work through this example. Calculate the dot product of vectors u and v, where vector u is negative 3i plus j, and vector v is 4k. To compute the dot product, using the definition we've learned so far, which was, to review that one more time, u dot v equals magnitude of u times magnitude of v times cosine of theta. Okay, so that's what we're going to use here. So to compute the dot product using this, we're going to need to know the angle between these vectors. So let's just start out by doing a rough sketch of these vectors in the XYZ space, just to get a sense of what we're dealing with here. Okay, so here I've just sketched an XYZ space for us to deal with. All my tick marks here just represent one unit. So let's start by thinking about what the vector u looks like in this space. So vector u, we have negative 3i plus j. So that tells us, first of all, that we're just in the xy plane. There's no z component of that vector. And I've moved negative 3 units in the x direction and 1 unit in the positive y direction. Okay, so if I kind of sketch that vector in, this is what it might look like. Okay, so here is a sketch of vector u. Now, once again, remember that this is solely in the xy plane. It's a little unfortunate. It may be hard to see on this picture here, but there's no z component to this vector. It has no vertical component. So let's also try to sketch in vector v. Now, vector v is 4k, so that is solely in the positive z direction. Okay, so that then is going to look like this. Okay, so here's vector v. Okay, so let's think about what we have here. Let's think about the angle between these vectors. Okay, so if I can maybe take from this drawing and simplify it a little, my vector u is in this xy plane. Okay. And then my vector v is solely in the z direction, like this. Okay, so here's vector v, and here's vector u. It's so what we see here is that the angle between these vectors is actually 90 degrees. Okay, so they're perpendicular. Or another word we use to describe that is orthogonal. So remember that when you have orthogonal vectors, their dot product is actually zero. Okay, so why does that happen? Why is it zero? Well, the cosine of 90 degrees, or we will write it as pi over 2, is 0. So in this case, it doesn't even really matter what the magnitude of these vectors are. Whatever it is, it's going to get us 0. So the dot product between these vectors is 0.